folks, just a quick update on the J.A.P. Model 3. Ex-ALCO generating plant engine. Not quite sure when it dates from, I guess sometime in the 1940s, it's World War II era. And found plenty of olive green paint on it. But this is how it's looking now, it's just pieced together, I might add. This week I've particularly been working on the governor assembly, or speed control rather, which is fitted on this bracket here. So I cleaned all that up, and I've had to make a new spindle for the adjuster, which works quite nicely. I've also had to make various repairs to the bracket here, like drilling out seized machine screws, replacing them, which is not easy when you're trying to drill a harder material out of a softer material, but we got there in the end. Got all that cleaned up. Pretty pleased with it considering how it looked. There is one part missing there, which is the slow idle lever. It should be like a, it's just a bit of flat steel. It goes across there and it acts on that pin there. That is the adjustment, and it will set a low idle. So when you finish your job, whatever you were doing, you could flip that up, it would shut the throttle almost and just keep it at a tick over. Another bit that was missing was the link there, and it should be a somewhat more complicated thing than that with an adjuster at each end, but I reckon I've got the length about right. And you can make final adjustment with the position of this bracket on the butterfly shaft there on the spindle. So that keeps it simple, and it works well. I just heated up that brass wire to get it to bend that well. Otherwise it tended to want to split. But I'm quite pleased with how it's come out. Just another little job I've done is to make up the HT lead, cut that to length, and with this bracket it loops around quite neatly. I've got a proper terminal for it, just looks a bit nicer. I believe that the suppressed caps, like you get on modern lawnmowers, that kind of thing, they're not good for old magnetos. So you want a proper terminal like that, really. Another issue I've had is with the studs that go into the block at the front. Had to bore all these out and fit larger ones, or, you know, tap a larger thread because of the corrosion in there. But that's all repaired now. And I've also just fitted the transfer on the front of the cowling. Not quite sure what to do for the exhaust yet. I did start making up a little like press fit stub that would go on there and be clamped in place, but managed to make a mistake on that and ruined the job. So I'll have to make another one. Thinking a 1-inch BSP adapter of some sort, and then I can fit a silencer. Planning to pair this engine with the Lister Brothers blower, but I'm not too sure at the moment. The blower is just over the back here. It's one of those things, it's quite interesting with the fast and loose pulley, but there's no real practical use for it, and it'll be a little difficult to display it actually doing something. So I'm half tempted to try and find a little piston compressor, because that kind of thing is really useful for pumping up tyres and so on, and it's much easier to show it actually working. So either way, it's going to end up on a little steel barrow trolley. Got some cast iron wheels and barrow handles for it. So plenty more work to be done. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed the video, and I'll update you again very soon.